Chapter 11, Transportation in Animals and Plants. You have learnt earlier that all organisms need food, water and oxygen for survival. They need to transport all these to various parts of their body. Further, animals need to transport waste to parts from where they can be removed. Have you wondered how all this is achieved? Look at figure 11.1. Do you see the heart and the blood vessels? They function to transport substances and together form the circulatory system. In this chapter, you shall learn about transport of substances in animals and plants. Circulatory system. Blood. What happens when you get a cut on your body? Blood flows out. But what is blood? Blood is the fluid which flows in blood vessels. It transports substances like digested food from the small intestine to the other parts of the body. It carries oxygen from the lungs to the cells of the body. It also transports waste for removal from the body. How does the blood carry various substances? Blood is composed of a fluid called plasma in which different types of cells are suspended. One type of cell are red blood cells. It is RBC, which contain a red pigment called hemoglobin. Hemoglobin binds with the oxygen and transports it to all parts of the body. And ultimately to all the cells, it will be difficult to provide oxygen efficiently to all the cells of the body without hemoglobin. The presence of hemoglobin makes blood appear red. The blood also has white blood cells, WBC, which fight against germs that may enter our body. Bojo fell down while playing a game and his knee got injured. Blood was coming out from the cut. After some time, he noticed that bleeding had stopped and a dark red clot had plugged the cut. Bojo was puzzled about this. The clot is formed because of the presence of another type of cells in the blood called platelets. Blood vessels. There are different types of blood vessels in the body. You know that during inhalation, a fresh supply of oxygen fills the lungs. Oxygen has to be transported to the rest of the body. Also, the blood picks up the waste materials, including carbon dioxide from the cells. This blood has to go back to the heart for transport to the lungs for removal of carbon dioxide, as you have learned in chapter 10. So, two types of blood vessels, arteries and veins, are present in the body. Arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from the heart to all parts of the body. Since the blood flows in a rapid and at high pressure, the arteries have thick elastic walls. Let us perform an activity. Study the flow of blood through arteries. Activity 11.1. Place the middle and index finger of your hand, right hand, on the inner side of your left wrist. Can you feel some throbbing movements? Why do you think there is a throbbing? This throbbing is called as a pulse and it is due to the blood flowing in the arteries. Count the number of pulse beats in 1 minute. How many pulse beats could you count? The number of beats per minute is called as a pulse rate. A resting person usually has a pulse rate between 72 and 80 beats per minute. Find other places in your body where you can feel the pulse. Record your own pulse beats per minute and those of your classmates. Insert the values you obtain in the table 11.1 and compare them. Veins are the vessels which carry carbon dioxide rich blood from all parts of the body back to the heart. The veins have thin walls. There are valves present in veins which allow blood to flow only towards the heart. Refer to figure 11.3. Do you see the arteries divide into smaller vessels? On reaching the tissue, they divide further into extremely thin tubes called capillaries. The capillaries join to form veins which empty into the heart. Heart. The heart is another organ. Is an organ which beats continuously to act as a pump for the transport of blood, which carries other substances with it. Imagine a pump working for years without stopping, absolutely impossible. Yet your heart works like a pump non-stop. Let us now learn about the heart. The heart is located in the chest cavity with its lower tip slightly tilted towards the left. Hold your fingers inwards on your palm. That makes your fist. Your heart is roughly the size of your fist. What will happen if the blood rich in oxygen and blood rich in carbon dioxide mix with each other? To avoid this from happening, the heart has four chambers. The two upper chambers are called as atria, singular atrium, and the two lower chambers are called as the ventricles. The partition between the chambers helps to avoid mixing of blood rich in oxygen with the blood rich in carbon dioxide. To understand the functioning of the circulatory system, start from the right side of the heart, figure 11.3, and follow the arrows These arrows show the direction of the blood flow from the heart to the lungs and back to the heart, from where it is pumped to the rest of the body. Heartbeat. The walls of the chambers of the heart are made up of muscles. These muscles contract and relax rhythmically. This rhythmic contraction followed by its relaxation constitute a heartbeat. Remember that heartbeat continue every moment of our life. If you place your hand on the left side of your chest, you can feel your heartbeat. The doctor feels your heartbeat with the help of an instrument called a stethoscope. A doctor uses this stethoscope as a device to amplify the sound of the heart. It consists of a chest piece that carries a sensitive diaphragm, two ear pieces and a tube joining the parts. Doctors can get clues about the condition of your heart by listening through a stethoscope. Let us construct a model of a stethoscope with the materials that are available around us. Activity 11.2. Take a small funnel of 6 to 7 cm in a diameter. Fix a rubber tube 50 cm long tightly on the stem of the funnel. Stretch a rubber sheet or a balloon on the mouth of a funnel and fix it tightly with a rubber band. Put the open end of the tube on one of your ears. Place the mouth of the funnel on your chest near the heart. Now try to listen carefully. Do you hear a regular thumping sound? The sound is that heart beats. How many times did your heart beat in a minute? Count again after running for 4 to 5 minutes. Compare your observations. Record your own pulse rate and heartbeat and that of your friends while resting and after running, and record in a table 11.2. Do you find any relationship between your heartbeat and a pulse rate? Each heartbeat generates one pulse rate in the arteries, and the pulse rate per minute indicates the rate of heartbeat. The rhythmic beating of the various chambers of the heart maintain circulation of the body, circulation of blood and transport of substances to the different parts of the body. Pooja wonders if sponges and hydra also have blood. Animals such as sponge and hydra do not possess any circulatory system. The water in which they live brings food and oxygen as it enters their body. The water carries away waste materials and carbon dioxide as it moves out. Thus, these animals do not need a circulatory fluid like the blood. Let us now learn about the removal of waste other than carbon dioxide. Excretion in animals. Recall how carbon dioxide is removed as a waste from the body through the lungs during the exhalation. Also recall that the undigested food is removed during exhalation. Let us now find out how the other waste materials are removed from the body. You may wonder where those unwanted materials come from. When our cells perform their function, certain waste products are released. These are toxic and hence need to be removed from the body. The process of removal of waste produced in the cells of the living organism is called excretion. The parts involved in the excretion from the excretory system. Excretory system in human being. The waste which is present in the blood has to be removed from the body. How can this be done? A mechanism to filter the blood is required. This is done by the blood capillaries in the kidneys. When the blood reaches the two kidneys, it contains both useful and harmful substances. The useful substances are absorbed back into the blood. The waste dissolved in water and are removed as urine. From the kidneys, the urine goes into the urinary bladder through tube-like uterus. It is stored in the bladder and is passed out through the urinary opening at the end of a muscular tube called urethra. The kidneys, uterus, bladder and urethra form the excretory system. An adult human being normally passes about 1 to 1.8 liter of urine in 24 hours. The urine consists of 95% of water, 2.5% of urea and 2.5% of other waste products. We have all experienced that we sweat on a hot summer day. The sweat contains water and salts. Bujo has seen that sometimes in summer white patches are formed on our clothes, especially in areas like underarms. These marks are left by salt present in the sweat. Does sweat serve any other functions? We know that the water kept in a earthen pot matka is cooler. This is because of the water evaporates from the pores of the pot, which causes cooling. Similarly, when we sweat, it helps to cool our body. Transport of substances in plants. In chapter 1, you have learned that plants take water and mineral nutrients from the soil through the roots and transport it to the leaves. The leaves prepare food
for the plant using water and carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. You also learned in a chapter 10 that the food is the source of energy and every cell of an organism gets energy by breakdown of the glucose. The cells use this energy to carry out vital activities of life. Therefore, food must be made available to every cell of an organism. Have you ever wondered how water and nutrients absorbed by the root and are transported to the leaves? How is the blood prepared by the leaves? How is the food prepared by the leaves carried to the parts which cannot make food? Transport of water and minerals. Plants absorb water and minerals by the roots. The roots have root hair. The root hair increases the surface area of the root for the absorption of water and mineral nutrients dissolved in water. The root hair is in contact with the water present between the soil particles. Can you guess how water moves from a root to the leaves? What kind of transport system is present in plants? Well, Buzo is right. Plants have a pipe-like vessels to transport water and nutrients from the soil. The vessels are made of special cells forming the vascular tissue. A tissue is a group of cells that perform a specialized function in an organism. The vascular tissue for the transport of water and nutrients in the plant is called the xylem. The xylem forms a continuous network of channels that connects the roots to the leaves through the stem and branches and thus transports water to the entire plant. You know that the leaves synthesize food. The food has to be transported to the all parts of the plant. This is done by the vascular tissue called phloem. Thus, xylem and phloem transport surfaces in plants. Does any part of the hair appear red? If yes, how do you think the color reached here? So you can cut the stem across and look for the red color inside the stem. From this activity, we see that water moves up the stem. In other words, stem conducts water just like the red ink minerals dissolved in water also move up the stem along with water. Water and minerals go to the leaves and other plants part through narrow tubes, xylem inside the stem. Transpiration. In class 6, you learned that plants release a lot of water by the process of transpiration. Plants absorb mineral nutrients and water from the soil. Not all the water absorbed is utilized by the plant. The water evaporates through the stomata present on the surface of a leaves by the process of transpiration. The evaporation of water from leaves generates a suction pull, the same that you produce when you suck water from a straw, which can pull water to great heights in the tall trees. Transpiration also pulls the plant. Thank you.